As a single 25-year-old female living with type 1 diabetes, dating definitely is impacted a little bit by the fact that I have this immense, important disease. You know, it's a huge part of my life. So if I meet a guy who can't handle that, I want to know right off the bat that it's too much for him. Some people, you know, absolutely might choose not to reveal that they have diabetes right away. Whatever, you know, it's your choice. It's absolutely your choice. I personally try to reveal it as quickly as it's appropriate. You know, it's not like, hey, I'm Ginger, I have diabetes. But at some point within the first couple conversations, I bring it up. I say it straight out. I have type 1 diabetes. I take injections a billion times a day. But if it didn't come up in conversation around what I do for a living, you know, then it would come up with when I need to take an injection at my meal. Or if I used an insulin pump, it would come up when I need to press buttons for my bolus. And I would say, you know, just so you know, I have type 1 diabetes and I have to take insulin with my meal. I count the carbs. I absolutely will take my injection in front of them on the first date, because if that bothers you, if you find it gross, disgusting, whatever, I don't really want to date you anymore. You know, some people really cannot handle pumps and tubing and infusion sites and syringes and bleeding from your fingers a billion times a day. They think it's gross, they get grossed out by it, they feel uncomfortable with the immense responsibility of the disease. It doesn't mean they're bad people, but it definitely means they're not somebody that I want to date. You know, if I wanted to, I suppose I could kind of fumble around what I do for a living. I could say, oh, I work in health. I write about health. I talk about health topics. And I could keep the word diabetes out of our conversations for like, you know, 3, 4, 5 dates. I could take my injections in the bathroom when we go out to dinner. I could check my blood sugar under the table. I could hide it. If I really wanted to, I could probably hide it. I've never done that before. But I don't want to have to hide it. Right? I want to be surrounded by people who can handle it, who can accept that I have this disease that I have to manage all the time. And when it comes to dating, you definitely better be able to be in the kitchen and handle the heat. You know what I mean? I don't hide the fact that I have this disease from somebody that I'm on a first date with, because their immediate response to that is very telling about what kind of person they are. I personally believe there's a difference between someone who doesn't know anything about diabetes and they are uncomfortable with it because they don't know much, but that person who just doesn't know much and wants to know more, they'll show that they want to know more if you show that you're willing to teach them more. But a person who doesn't know much and doesn't want to know more and is freaked out by it, that'll be obvious. You know, they won't ask questions. They'll just kind of like ignore that part of your life. I wouldn't want to be friends with people who can't handle that I have diabetes, so I definitely don't want to date people who can't handle that I have diabetes. Personally, my advice for you if you are single and dating with diabetes is to be upfront, is to be honest and present it as part of many things that make up who you are. And just as you would want someone to accept you for being a brunette or being someone who doesn't eat dairy or whatever, you also want them to accept that you have this disease that you need to manage on a regular basis. And it involves things like blood and insulin and shots and whatever. You know, it's part of who you are. And if they don't like that, then they're not for you. You know, to me, dating, you know, if I want to date you, it's because I see who you are and I am accepting everything about you, whether it's perfect or imperfect or whatever. And part of who I am is a person with diabetes. It's not all of who I am. But if you're going to embrace me and you're going to like me for me, that means that you're liking a redhead, someone who doesn't like tuna fish. I don't run fast. I can move heavy stuff. I love chocolate. I love Arnold Schwarzenegger. I have diabetes. I can't swim very well. You know, these are all qualities of who I am, and diabetes is one of those qualities. And it's a big one. It's important. So if you're going to like me, you're going to like all of me.